You know how I feel. Ooh, 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 ooh. You know how I feel. You know how I feel. You know how I feel. Ooh, 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 ooh. You know how I feel. You know how I feel. You know how I feel. Ooh, 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 ooh. You know how I feel. You know how I feel. Thank you. and you know how I feel. Ooh, 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 ooh. And you know how I feel. And you know how I feel. And you know how I feel. Ooh, 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 ooh. And you know how I feel. And you know how I feel.
Are you also hearing that? You are. There I am. Oh, well, okay. Let me catch up on some of the comments here. Nice to see everybody. Megan's here. Sweet. Rita. Shelly. Shelly, you've been a great addition. We really appreciate you joining us. I thought I saw Luis is here. Megan's here. Kelly's here. Carla's here. Victoria's here. Lindsay's here. Jennifer's here. That's okay, guys. That's okay. I came up with a bad idea. Yeah, no, I had a bad idea while you guys weren't here. And it just said, Ariana's here. Rita's here. Yeah, no ceilings or furniture. That's best. That would be awesome. Okay, so let's... I have actually taken some notes for this class because I don't want to get too lost. Let's... I appreciate roll call. You guys, if I missed you, chime in again because I'm nervous and I'm reading these comments and I'm old and stuff gets kind of blurry. So let's see. There's Tara and Rex. He's going to be skipping out during the sway, so we're just waiting on that to start. There's Tara again. There's old Annabelle. Good old Annabelle. Okay. And then we'll go back. Okay. Shayna. Oh, sweet. Sweet. Sorry. Jackie's here. Sweet. I was hoping everybody would be here. Okay, cool. So I want to talk about this class. So this was a request tonight, and the requester asked for basically a class talking about processing big emotions, like how to get through them, which is not to be too clinical, but that is what we call processing. And then grieving for the life you thought you would have. And when she wrote that and said grieving for the life you thought you would have, I just thought how universal that feels in your 40s or 50s. And I actually never thought of my life at this far. And now I wish I had. Like a lot of young dudes in my Gen X dudes, I thought I was going to be dead by 25. And so I just never even considered what it would be like to be alive at this point. And so I can really relate, not so much to the grieving of the life you thought you would have, but the grieving of the life you could have had. And I feel like a lot of us, not all of us, hopefully none of you, but I have a feeling it's a stronger percentage than I wish, struggle from what could have been-ness. And you have no idea. It's just there's something that makes you insecure about what you have that even makes you think there could have been a better. And sometimes that's based in reason, and sometimes it's just based in fear and just paranoia. And that experience of handling that type of reflection in the mirror makes me think of this story that I heard from Ram Dass a long time ago, where, and Tara is a Ram Dass aficionado, so you correct me if I move, but my understanding, I think I heard this in the Transformation of a Man series, but Bhagwan Das, Ram Dass is having a tough time, and I feel like they're either on the way to meet the guru or they are at, it's after they've met the guru, and basically Ram Dass is, Richard Alpert is starting to struggle with the struggle. And Bhagwan Das explains to them as they're walking, he describes like the sound of his flip-flops and all this sort of stuff, as saying that these emotions that you're feeling are like water rolling over you. That they're just that they are like the temper of the sea as it rolls over, and that can be stillness, almost like an agonizing stillness, which is kind of what the Thoreau quote references, or it can be just raging. And what is innate in what Bhagwan Das is saying and how Ram Dass processes it is in the idea of the impermanence of emotion. That this too shall pass can be painful to say to ourselves, but it can be helpful when you're dealing, especially with shitty feelings. That this too shall pass. That this is not my identity. This is the waves over me right now. That I'm not deserving of this. This is just what is there. So I am taking that story and idea and applying it to the Maidan, and I am imagining us as Maidan sailors tonight. I can imagine Beth Lavender actually wrote a Maidan character, and it was a sailor Maidan, but I don't remember her name, and I don't remember, unfortunately, any of her stories. But Beth was the first one. And then what was funny is that after that, when I toured and traveled, several people would talk about, were there any ocean Maidan? And I can only imagine that if you listen to nature, that if you believe in rhythm, if you observe, that you'd be an awesome sailor. So it makes total sense. And so the way that I'm presenting the class tonight is that there are lots of emotions that we're all feeling right now, and we're just going to sail them. We're just going to navigate through them as best we can, not trying to conquer them, but trying to just be, you know, in oneness with them. All right. Did that make sense?
Yeah.
All right. Breath in. Audible breath in. I imagine that my Dan were very attracted to sailing. I mean, what could be more perfect for them than wind and current? It's easy for me to step into the my Dan that's comfortable with sailing. Because she understands that weather turns, that waves calm, and she knows that however dire or wonderful the moment is that she's in, that it's fleeting. Therefore, it needs to be held on to with gratitude as long as she can. Bhagwan Das's imagery as we open up tonight, and you can think that every thought and every feeling that you're having now as you close your eyes and sway is water passing over, and you can look up from the floor And instead of being those waters, you can watch those waters. Audible breath in. Sometimes when you hold something too close to your face, it's out of focus. And you can feel your brain trying to imagine where the real lines are. But when you push it away, it comes into focus. And that's the first step in sailing. To not guess what the wind is doing, but to sail with what the wind is doing. To react and to feel and to observe. Audible breath in. You guys. All right. Okay. There we go. Yeah. Well, sometimes I look up quotes before class, and there are so many great sailing quotes. To be honest, it's really a helpful metaphor. All right. What's that?
Drops of quotes.
Drops of what?
Do you have any quotes to your sailing?
Oh, I didn't write them down. Yeah, I didn't copy and paste. Anne's asking me if I had any quotes, and they're really good, but I don't have them. I mean, I think the quote on the promo is pretty good. Okay. That's fine. All right. So the way that I usually teach these type of classes, this is pretty good. The way that I teach these type of classes is they're more flow based. And so what Tara's doing right now is perfect. She's just finding her flow while I sort of set up the meditative focus. one of my... Maybe I should bring this down just a second and just explain this. But one of my favorite My Dan stories is when the My Dan teach Darsha how to swim, because Darsha is blind and her mother dies in the river. So she's like doubly afraid. And so they take her out to the water, and there's like, you know, four or five of them holding this little girl up. And they just sort of hold her while she sort of floats on her back. And they sing to her. So that's the kind of vision we'll get into for. Imagine being gently dropped into this water that we're sailing. Imagine being like lovingly made comfortable with this mystery. Testing. There we go. All right. Sweet. I am catching up on some comments here. Yeah, totally. You know, one of my mentors said to me about this idea of gripping too tight. He said, you want loose control with your students. You want loose control. For whatever reason, that totally made sense to me. Okay. Do you guys have any thoughts, comments, or... All right. No, that's fine. You don't need any. Tara, anything to say before we move on? Okay. Okay, so I am positive that this playlist is going to get us kicked off of Facebook. And admittedly, I'm being a little cute tonight and I'm playing songs with the word sailor in them. But I want to do it anyway. And so what I would advise for this song is that you do, while I talk to you about this sort of sailing idea, is that you pick a move that you feel really comfortable falling into the zen of. Like, so it could be waist tubing, it could be vertical rolling. For me, it's always weaving and vertical rolling. That's like always my entry. It used to be waist tubing, but now it's kind of that, and that's sort of what pulls me in. So you'll just pick that, whatever that opening entry is. You don't have to stick to it, but just pick anything to sort of start on. But you are going to sort of like be repetitive with it. And we're going to start off super chill.
Sail across the sea. Now I'm just an island since they took my boat away from me. Oh no.
Audible breath in.
I don't like being stationary.
No, whatever no, repetitive no. movement you want, whatever
I
sort
like
of opening
the
movement. Of course I am. Of course I'm going to play Christopher Cross's Sailing.
He wrote his eulogy. He said, think that I can die now. But my true love won't come for me.
Set me free, set me free, set me free. tea. Rex is being a good boy right now. All right. Did I kind of cheese out with that last one a little bit?
No, I was loving that one, and I actually had a breakthrough because I realized that repetitiveness was really good for me because I kind of was doing a new move.
And saying, if you can't hear her, she's saying that repetitiveness was good for her because she was kind of doing a new move,
yeah,
which is right there.
Because I started doing this, you know, which I wasn't doing before, but just because of doing the same thing over and over again. So
nice. All right, there we go.
Always
Tara, anything?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Okay. All right. So we are going to have our first sort of expression type exercise. Yeah, that was Tracy Chapman. Yeah, it's called I Used to Be a Sailor. One of the reasons I want you to do something repetitive, I want you to listen to the lyrics because I am the biggest Tracy Chapman lyric fan ever. I think she's like...
You're a Tracy Chapman stan.
Yeah, I am definitely a stan. Yeah, I was in college when that came out. Okay. Right. So we're going to try our first exercise and... This is sort of like related to what we're talking about, but it's going to seem kind of like sort of out there at first. But you're going to pick some way of holding the hoop that you feel comfortable, like it could be actually holding it or whatever technique that feels good to you. And then we're going to try a little bit of sort of this sort of sea walking type motion. It's similar to Drunken Master, but it's a little bit smarter than that. So you sort of, I've done this in workshops before, it can be pretty fun. You sort of imagine that you are on a sort of, you know, shifting deck with your hooping, whatever that would mean to you, whatever degree of shift that is. You just imagine that you're on a shifting deck. And so whatever technique you have to do to be on the shifting deck is what you want. So if that's core hooping, that's core hooping or whatever. All right. One more sailor song. This is definitely gonna kick. If you're on Facebook, switch to YouTube fast.
I'm undecided about you again. Mightn't be right that you're not here. It's double-sided. 'Cause I ruined it all, but also saved myself by never believing you, dear.
If you get lost
everything
in a bad way, then just
true.
Come back to a shifting deck. Just imagine,
everything
you know,
else is just
you are hooping on deck.
Everything I have to look forward to.
Man down, man down.
Oh, Santa, why'd you do it? What'd you do that for? Saying there's nothing to it, letting it go by the boards. Oh, Santa, why'd you do it? What'd you do that for? Saying there's nothing to it. Playing with 52 cards just 'cause I play so far from my vest. Whatever I've got no reason to guard. What could I do but spend my best? Oh, sailor, why'd you do it? What'd you do that?
As you're melting back and forth, you're developing your sea legs, as it were, your sea legs. And not to discourage younger people, but encourage them that your sea legs develop, that you get better at riding waves as you get older. Tara says she wishes she had gone on vacation. Tara's been working a bunch, y'all. Actually, I could probably fix this problem, but... Yeah, but it's totally different with kittens. You could actually, like, hurt somebody. Okay. Okay, so we're going to... I'm going to keep the energy going up just... Oops, sorry. I'm going to keep the energy going up just for a moment. And I have played this song on the stream before. I love this track. This is intended to be a core hooping track, but if you're feeling not core, you do not have to core hoop to this track or whatever. But this, and I don't want to overwork the sailing metaphor, but this is a sort of a track to help us sort of break through the breakers. You know, to swim out past the sort of breaking waves to get to that sort of deeper place or paddle out if we're sailing or whatever it is. And that, we all know this metaphor to be true. It's like the initial crashes of the waves when we make that endeavor out can really affect whether we ever try it again. And so it can sometimes discourage us before we really should be discouraged, because the first time we went out, it just randomly happened to be a big wave. Right, and so sometimes it's just good to have this, you know, sort of stick-to-itness of purpose that you're gonna push through, and that can help you deal with these emotional waves. Is to think about your purpose, like, and I don't mean that necessarily in the spiritual sense, but just to think about your purpose. That, like, what is the ground that water is rushing over? All right, core hooping. Or not. You don't have to core hoop. I'm just saying that I'm gonna core hoop. But this is more about just a sort of meditative experience of stick-to-itiveness. Thoughts, comments, sir?
I was having a lot of fun just hooping like right here.
And let me show you on, put you on. There we go. You're having a lot of fun doing what?
Just hooping right here.
I don't know.
Giving us.
To be in between the chest and the waist?
Yeah, which I can only do with my bigger hoop. But it was really fun, good feeling.
Sarah's saying, Anne is saying that it helps with her thoracic spine, and Tara is explaining to her why. Oh, there we go. Okay. So I don't want to be too metaphorical here, but this is what happens to me sometimes. So I thought we would do it in a hoop exercise. Sometimes the wind and me and the water and everything are perfect. And I am feeling like I am like surfing, sailing, flowing, whatever, like with everything. And it's not like I crash. It's just like the wind goes away. It's just like all of a sudden, like all the wind I was using is gone. All the like currents I was flowing on are just gone. It's just things go still. And so I thought we would do this, you know, maybe to take some of the scariness away of it, was to do it as an exercise. So we're about to make everything go still. You can hoop any way you want to. I'm going to do point technique. This is one of my, you guys have hooped to this one before too. This is one of my favorite point songs, but this is when the current goes still, okay? We're going to take the scary of that out right now.
Thank you.
That's one of her best, I think. I really dig that song. Do y'all have any tea, anything to say? Tara? I mean, Ann, anything to say? Ann was into it. Okay. All right, so so I looked up sailing metaphors. Right, so I was looking up pictures, and I was trying to look, because originally I was going to do this on like windless sails, right? And so I'm looking up windless sails as images, and it talks about what happens when there's no wind. And I was like, okay, that's interesting. And they said, well, obviously you paddle. And I thought, well, that's perfect. That's perfect. That's perfect metaphorically. That's perfect in hoop path land, that like when we are feeling stagnant, that we paddle. So we are going to paddle. So one of the things I'll just set up for everyone super quick. Paddling is anytime you push the hoop. It's anytime your arm makes any kind of contact with the hoop, that is paddling. And if I'm paddling is almost all, well, so Anne does some paddles that happen from the outside wall. But generally, if you're a beginner to intermediate, most of the paddles are coming, you're pushing from the inside wall out, inside wall of the hoop. A lift is just an extended paddle, and your lifts will get a lot better if you think of it that way. A paddle stall is when I paddle and then turn with the hoop, like turning it into a stall. These make some people crazy, you know, dizzy, and some people really dig it, but it can be fun to try it. Paddle stall, I just paddle, but then I turn at the same time, and that puts the hoop to sleep on my hand or my arm or wherever it is. But the point of this and why I'm bringing it into our sailing class is that when we are windless, it's a little hot on my mic, when we are windless, we can just paddle. So we're going to work on paddling for the next 3 minutes. Slice catch, that's funny. That was a good one. Being too metaphorical, paddling is creating current. When you push the hoop, you're creating current. So you can speed the hoop up by just giving it one well-timed push. You don't have to keep hitting the hoop. You can just give it one well-timed push. The genesis of paddling was to keep it alive, to keep the rotation alive. So if you were coming out of like a earth angle on the core with a big hoop and it was about to die, you would push it. It's just you giving the push to it just to assist it. And then it became kind of a style, but originally it was just to resuscitate your hoop flow. Another minute. That's nice, Shelly. Thank you for saying that. Shelly said it was nice to watch all three of us. I love drumming. Used to be my favorite thing to hoop to for a long time. Okay. How are you guys feeling?
Good.
Okay. Oh, we're already past 8 o'clock. I didn't realize it. That song was really fun. Okay. Yeah, I think we should free hoop from here. Yeah, we'll just free hoop, and I'll just stick with my. Actually, we'll slip this guy in. We'll move into free hoop. Thank you, guys. My next class will be Thursday. Thank you, Tara. Thank you, Anne. This is the free hoop here.
Life goes on. Until the evil all dies and change skies. And when I talk to you, I'ma look in your eyes and blow bomb chronic smoke in your face like surprise. Cause this right here could very well be the last time that you ever hear from me. But if the beat don't stop and we party and pass through, remember live long, love life and be free. Cause when fights break out, girls scream and dust settles. I'm just another tattered late bloomer from out the ghetto. Surrounded by turntables, drums, guitars, pedals, microphones, amps, mixes, EQs and peak levels. Angels, devils, copycats, and hypocrites. Jackasses, know-it-alls, road dogs, and dipshits. Nut riders, bitches, they claiming they all different. All of this is why I'm getting lifted,
Feeling Jezebel and punk, come on, all in a row. Some live for silver and gold, while others just need someone to owe. In this rough old life of good and bad, trying to free their soul. Up, and away we go.
Yeah. With all the violence being heard these days, who needs pictures? Troopers be get stretched like limbs on Reed Richards. See, I personify calm winds and tree switches, and verbally feed the masses like Jesus with three fishes. The scene switches when people are not feeling me, faced with hostility. Bottles and rocks still with me, even in auxiliary mode. The trooper be told, koofies and gold, bring the new from the old. I'm true to my soul, despite all the obstacles. Melt them like popsicles. Let these imposters know we do the impossible. Hopping on top, making your trunk knock like Funk Doc. Connecting hip-hop and punk rock in one shot. I'm just another rapper alive, surviving tour bus crashes with drivers who couldn't drive. Cadavers who wouldn't strive ain't blessed with strong speech. My songs teach, broadcasted live from Long Beach.
I'm like, sensitive, but I feel wonder what I go on in the island. And the situation, me not know if he say. But all I know, say them matter about religion. And I kill one another, me say each and every day. Well, them burning churches, killing babies, fear bad news in the pages. It's like we going through a different stages, a different stages and phases.
With all the wonders of the world, Jack create them all for us to see. Good, bad,
you're very welcome, Shanna. Thank you, Tara. Thank you, Anna. Thank you, Lindsay, Rita, Shelly. This next song, I'll just admit, this next song might be challenging for some of you that never hooped to R&B to hoop to, that this will be our second to the last song tonight. You can stretch, hoop, whatever feels good. It's admittedly difficult, though. You're welcome, Jackie. I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Woke up in the morning, looked out the window and saw.
Thank you, Vicky. Appreciate
everyone
it.
Playing looked like they had
I love it when you get a chance to join.
Traveling freely, ran out to join him as one. Seemed to be so much fun. All day I dream of winning. All day I dream I'm sailing away. Selling away. want me to play so long. The sun started going down.
Living life for free.
I could go day and all night. I'm game and feeling alright.
Trying to tell you that you're
my victory.
Expected song of the night.
I'm chicken after you.
And I'm not even gonna make Tara and Ann dance to it.
The all day I dream. Letter today. I really appreciate it.
For this part or not? The most challenging song in the world to hit to. But okay. All right, here we go. This is the most challenging song to hoop to in the world, but it's actually an awesome song. Yeah. Thank you guys for joining us tonight. This is our last track. Everybody knew this was coming. Over 30, 40.
Every word is a symphony, won't you believe?
find serenity. Oh, the canvas can do miracles. Just you wait and see. Then believe me.
I don't, Vicky, I don't know Rod Stewart's sailing song. I only know Christopher Cross. Maybe my Americanism just showed up. Thank you, Anne. Thank you, Tara. Yay. And thank you, guys. Britishness. Oh, right. Duh. That's right. I forget that sometimes. Vicky. I'll look it up. All right. Anyway, thank you, guys, for a great night. And please keep those suggestions coming if you have them. I really like getting them. Sometimes I can do them quickly, like tonight, and sometimes I can't, but I really, really appreciate all of them. So anyway, have a great night, y'all.
Something like a savage. I done found myself when I was lacking.